I'm going to hand that back to you for the IC one here. Nice try, though. I'll take that one.
Ted and Joanne have been married 25 years and have a close-knit family, one that has seen many members on Ted's side develop and pass away from Alzheimer's disease. Because of the strong genetic risk in his family, Ted was tested in 2008 at age 43.
And unfortunately, it was positive that he wanted to be able to do whatever he could to, as he used to say, be the guinea pig to help find a cure.
He's now doing just that. Ted is one of the first Canadian patients to participate in a new international study. It's the first of its kind to see if Alzheimer's can be stopped or delayed in this high-risk genetic group, which make up about 1% of all patients with the disease. As simulated here, study participants are injected or infused monthly with one of two experimental drugs or placebo and receive brain scans every few months to monitor their safety and to check for adverse effects. Dr. Mario Macellis is the lead investigator at Sunnybrook.
We are really, really hoping to tackle the underlying protein problem or proteinopathy. And proteinopathy just means accumulation of an abnormal protein that's causing damage to the brain.
The proteins researchers believe go awry in Alzheimer's are called amyloid and tau. They become sticky, accumulate, and interfere with normal brain function. And for patients like Ted, in the prime of life, that's causing a steady decline in his ability to do the things he used to love, like play sports and interact with friends and family.
It's a devastating disease because everyone is affected by this. You know, within 5 to 10 years of developing symptoms of genetic Alzheimer's disease, patients are often dependent on other family members.
Ted and Joanne say this trial offers hope to find a possible treatment and spare others the heartbreak they're living every day.
We just feel it's important to do something while we have the opportunity to do it. So it's hard, but it's promising.
With Sunnyview, I'm Monica Mattis.